I'm Gayle Laakmann McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. Today we're going to talk about detecting if a tree is actually a valid binary search tree. A binary search tree, as you may recall, is a binary tree, so it has a left node and right node, but it's one where all the nodes on the left, for any given node, all the nodes on its left are smaller than it, and all the nodes on its right are bigger than it. So we want to check to make sure a binary tree is actually a binary search tree. And so that means checking to make sure that ordering property is true. So one approach that a lot of people take that is actually mistaken is they think, okay, I'll just walk through my tree and check to make sure for any given node, compare it to the left node, compare it to the right node, and see if it's in the right order. So is the left node smaller than the current node and smaller than the right? And the problem with that is that even if that's true, it may not be a valid binary search tree because there could be something else underneath it that's bigger than the parent. So for any given root, maybe its grandchild is actually bigger than it, and maybe its left grandchild is actually bigger than it. So that won't actually work. Another approach that is correct but slow is we can say, okay, all the nodes on the left must be smaller than all the nodes on the right. So take each node, get the biggest node on the left, compare it to this node, get the smallest node on the right, compare it to that node. That'll work, but it's pretty inefficient. These get min and get max operations require walking through that whole tree. So that's gonna actually get very, very slow. A faster way is we can flip around this logic. We can say, okay, at the very beginning, our root is valid. The root can be anything in the entire world. But when we go to the left, we're gonna walk through all of its children. And when we go to the left, everything on the left has to be between the integer minimum and the root value. And everything on the right has to be between the root value and the integer maximum. Okay, so now let's go to the left. Well, that, you know, we'll check to make sure, hey, is that node on the left, is that within those values? Great, it is. Okay, keep going. Now, when we go to the right side of that, all those values must be between that left node's value and that root node's value. So we're going to pass around these ranges of min and max and say, at any given point, are you within that min and max range? So that's how we tackle this problem. Okay, so what we need for this method actually is we need check BST to take in a min and max value. And this initial node is going to just take in, pass an integer.min. So initially, the root can be any value at all, actually. Now I'm gonna specify here, these are inclusive ranges. Okay, so in the very beginning, first I wanna check to make sure my root is in the right value. So if it's smaller than my min, or it's bigger than my max, return false. I also want to be careful of, I need a base case here. So if root is null, then return true. Otherwise, go left or right. So check my left and right. Root dot left. And I'm going to come back to what these ranges are in a second. So check the left and check the right. Both are valid, then it's valid. Okay, that's the basic logic. Now, initially, my root can be anywhere between min and max. If I go to the left of my root, anything down there can still be as small as the min, but it cannot be any bigger than the root. And in fact, it can't even be equal to the root because we actually do not have duplicates in this tree. And so my values on the left of my root can be anywhere between min at the smallest and one smaller than the root. When I go to the right, things can be they have to be at least as big as root, actually one bigger, and they can be up to that max value. Now let's run this and see what happens. Perfect, it worked. So we can do it, throw in more test cases if we want. But let's walk through what this does. So this basically flips around our initial logic. What we're gonna do is pass these ever shrinking min and max values. So the logic is basically root had to be somewhere between min and max. If we go to the left, we've now shrunken the biggest those values can be. They can be between that old minimum and root. If we go to the right, then they can be still as big as that max, but they can't. But they have to be at least as big as root. Now you want to be very careful on any recursive problems to pay extra close attention there to the base cases, because that's a really, really easy thing to mix up. One thing I always check for in a recursive problem is if I'm returning a Boolean, I definitely want to make sure that I have some sort of return true and some sort of return false statement somewhere. Because if I only have a return false statement, how would I ever get anything other than false? So that's just a quick little sanity check to do. Okay, so that's how we tackle this problem. The efficiency of this solution is actually really nice. We actually have a linear time solution, and we know since we have to touch every single node in the tree, we can't do any better than that. So this is pretty close to as optimal as we can get. And the space complexity, by the way, of this problem is going to be, if it's a balanced tree, it's going to be log n because of that recursive complexity. So now that you've seen this problem, why don't you try this again on your own or check out some new binary search tree problems. Good luck.